Okay, guys, good to see you again. Quick video to show you some of the features that are inside the web application. So you've seen the login. New features are, obviously, we've got the latest gold price being pulled in. This is updated every 10 minutes. The layers as before. And I've got the layer turned on here, which is the CZL not on live. It does seem to be one of the most popular layers we've got at the moment. First, if you go up here, you can click on your the menu icon. You go to the account, and then inside account, this will pop up and show information about your name, how to change the password, and a key one is manage the billing. And if you click on this one, it'll load a window from my credit card processing company. I don't store any credit card numbers, nothing at all. And so this is how you cancel your subscription. So for any particular reason, you're not happy with it, cancel the subscription. I've hit the cancel subscription button already on this one, but it does give you till the end of the month. It says your subscription will be canceled on November the 1st. Today is the 3rd of October. So I've still got all the access. And if in that time you decide to change your mind, hit the button up here and you will just continue on as before. You won't get charged again. You'll just continue on. But if you wait beyond the 1st of November, you will have to get a whole new thing set up. Once that's done, you can change credit card numbers, all that sort of stuff, add different payment methods, and then just return back here, return to Gold Prospecting WA. Change your password, it's pretty simple. It asks you for your current password. It'll ask you for your new password, and away you go. So that covers the account page. So let's go back to the map. So I'm just gonna zoom in on a bit out here. Let's turn on the geology. Let's go CZL. Seems to be a popular one at the moment. And let's concentrate on an area, say, out here. Kalgoorlie is out here. This is the trans line in here. There's some CZL marked here. To prove it is outside of the live tenements, let's go and turn on the live. And you can see that there's none sitting inside the live. It's crossing there. So as most of you have most probably figured out, you down the bottom, on the bottom left-hand corner, you can actually change the opacity for the various layers to highlight and mask. You can actually change the order of the layers. Now, sometimes it's a bit picky on things, but you either try moving it up. If it doesn't work, try moving it down, and it'll work just as well then. In case you just change that. And this is actually, this icon out here turns things off. If you're using a mouse-based program and not on an iPad, not on a phone, you'll see these little tooltips pop up. And they're all over the place. Like turn, this is like turn layer off. So if I click that, it turns the CZL off. Now, one of the things that I've had a couple of comments about, and that's probably a mistake on my part because it hasn't been super clear, is the little bar down the bottom where it says longitude, latitude. Obviously, that is in longitude, latitude. But if you move your mouse over, it says click to change the coordinate projection. So if I click it, it'll now get changed to NGA zone 50, which is coordinates that you can then go and type into your GPS and use that. And so if you continue on zooming around the map, these are all updated in NGA zone 50s. So let's go back to that long. Now, one of the other things that's floating around is the little icon down here. This is to change the base map. Click on this one. So you've got a map called OpenStreetMap, which is a simplistic map, which is the one we've got at the background now. I've got the classic Google satellite image, which all of us are familiar with. I've got the Landgate aerial imagery. So let's show you the difference. There's the Google imagery and the Landgate imagery. Now, why have I got two and which one is better? Well, technically, they're both better. The Landgate aerial imagery is a service put out by Landgate, which is the state government department here in WA, which has flown big chunks of the state with the plane with a camera in it taking aerial photos. A lot of the Google's imagery is satellite. And as you zoom down closer to the ground, you'll notice it starts to look like some of the trees and buildings and whatever in the rural areas, not in the metro areas, but out in the countryside, can start to look like melted plastic sort of things. The Landgate does give you a bit more resolution, not a hell of a lot. The colored balancing could be better, but we can't complain. And it also, the one of the good things about the two is they're both taken at different times. So the advantage is that you can see what looked like one may have been taken during a wet year and one was a dry year. So you can see maybe what scrapes are or not scrapes. So you choose either one of that. One of the bottom is just the classic 1 to 250,000 topo map. This is the one that's put out by GeoScience Australia. It is a standard topographic map showing roads and well names and whatnot floating around. It also has a number of mines as things floated on it. Not all of them are correct, but 90% of them are. Okay, so one of the things that also that you can do here, and I'll try to keep it super simple, is that you can actually drop a pin. Now, what you have to do is you have to create a layer first to put it on, because it doesn't know where to put it on. So what you go down to active layers, and there's this little plus, click on that, and it will create one. Apologies for the blue. But it's basically labeled it today's date and time. So it's 2005-10-03, obviously 3rd of October 2025, and a time and date. Now, you can actually change that, rename it, click on that, and go rename layer to call it my new layer. And it's now called that down the bottom. And I'll turn on another layer so we can actually see what it looks like. And I'll turn that to active. And you can see the one down the bottom says my new layer now. Okay. The once you clicked on that layer, and I'll and let's say we leave the CZL, because I want to mark interesting spots where the CZL is. Now I should show you an interesting spot I found. Okay, it's out here. I'll turn on some live. So there's some live. We've got some CZL running through here. I've checked it out. It doesn't look like there's any national parks or whatever on it, but it's worthwhile checking with another source. And please do not take this website as being the definitive authoritative site, to say, of all places where you can and cannot go. It's up to you to check. And I will turn on some gold locations. Gold locations. So these are gold locations that do falling through here. And I will turn on some... what am I looking for? So some faults, and I'll go the 500,000 faults. So you can see the number of faults running up through here. So there's a CZL, there's a known gold location. And so if I click on the gold location and I click on that, am I getting, maybe there's no, oh, there it comes. So it's a gold location, pretty, it's a Randall's, blah, blah, blah. And you can actually go off and find some more information. It's basically just an anomalous gold zone. Okay, so let's, leaving that on, and we close this one down, we can actually go and turn on some gold samples. And we can see around here, there's actually some interesting looking anomalous zones running along these faults. So doesn't look like anyone sampled this one, but it could be worth a go. So now that we've got those, I'm going to turn off some of these. Just to get rid of the noise, I will actually drop back these ones so it's easier to see on the screen. And I will click on my new layer. I'll go up here and choose, click a pin. The thing turns green at the top. Come over here, click on the map. And I got, say, interesting spot number one, CZL. Plus gold rotation, plus fault. And I'm going to choose a different color pin, this horrible pink thing, so I can see it against the background, and save. Okay. I then go off and do another one, and say there's another one down here, and say another spot. Now you can call them whatever you want. You don't have to fill out either of these to tell the truth, and I'll do another pink spot. Okay. Do as many as you want. Okay, when you reach the end of the day, if you click the close button, turn layer off, all the points that you put in are lost. Okay, so what I suggest doing is go to this one, and so download as GeoJSON. Use CSV only if you need to export it as something that is significantly retarded, but GeoJSON is pretty much the safe bet to wherever you go to. It Trilobite will very happily read this file format and actually display the little pins as well. So that's something to do. So download the GeoJSON. It'll come up and say, where do you want to put it? It's named it after the layer, and away it goes. Layer saved. Now I can turn that off. Okay, all the points are gone. Now, if I find my layer again, which is went to downloads, and I grab the layer and drag it back in, this is how you can reload it and just drop it on the map. You notice there's my two pins and it's zoomed to it. And if I say my new layer GeoJSON, I select that as my active layer and I click on the query next to it, it'll say, interesting spot number one, CZL Golod, blah, 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 blah. Okay. If you want to delete it, this is how you do it. Click the point, then click the delete feature. It's gone. If you, while placing points, decide that one of them is wrong, you do not have to save it and reload it just to edit it. You can come back and just click on it. I think that's enough information for now. Please let me know if you have any issues or whatever. We have had a bit of an outage today, but that seems to be sorting itself out. And I'm hoping you're enjoying it. Take care, guys. See ya.